Hi guys, this is SciGQG35 Security. Today, I will show you how to set Grub2 EFI on Windows 10 MBR. Explain set default Grub2 on EFI on Windows 10 MBR boot, so you can use only use with UEFI mode, BIOS with AIO boot Grub2 on the disk. MBR was already shrink it to FAT32 UEFI mode boot, so we can able to install on UEFI files on FAT32 UEFI disk. BCD Windows 10, MBR on FAT32 UEFI in AIO boot, disk X32.64. For searching Grub2 MBR or GPT, on FAT32 UEFI disk, an AIO boot disk install manually. To boot WinPE10, X.64-bit DLC or Linux, on BIOS mode, GPT. To check the BIOS mode, you should go to Start menu. Type info. Run as administrator. Click Yes. As you can see, BIOS mode is set on MBR Legacy in Windows 10. Exit system information. Go to the PC. Go to DVD drive DLC boot to install DLC boot on Windows 10 UEFI mode. You should copy dlcboot.exe and dlc1 file on AIO boot disk. Press Ctrl and hold on the keyboard, then select dlcboot.exe with dlc1. Right click and select copy. Go to AIO boot disk and right click select paste to start copy the DLC boot files. After done copy, you should now install WinPE10 on Windows 10. To do that, we need to use AIO boot to install WinPE10 on Windows 10. Open AIO boot. Click Yes. Go to Integration. Click Select Pack. Choose Windows. Choose WinPE7/8.1/10. Open the browser. Go to AIO boot disk. Select DLC1. Then select WinPE. Choose W10X64WM. Click Open. Click OK. Rename the WinPE and type DLC boot. WinPE10X64-bit. Then click OK. Notice, to save disk space, we will move this file instead of copying it. Do you agree? You can move the file WinPE to AIO boot file to save the space disk. Click Yes to complete install WinPE10. Click OK. After we done to install WinPE DCL boot, it's time to set Grub2 UEFI mode so we can boot up DLC boot on Windows 10 UEFI to do that. You need to shrink the disk and format on FAT32 UEFI and install BCD manually in FAT32 UEFI disk so you can able to install and copy files on AIO boot. If you don't know how to do that, you should watching this video. Now let's begin to set default on Grub2 UEFI on FAT32 UEFI disk. Click Bootloaders. Click Grub2. Click OK to set, as Grub2 Legacy is already installed. Notice Grub2 UEFI is detected. Disk format is F/296 MB FAT32. UEFI disk is going to install Grub2 Clover and refind for UEFI mode. Click OK. The files start install and copy on FAT32 UEFI disk. After you done complete install WinPE10 and Grub2 UEFI on Windows 10 MBR, you need to reboot the system and change the BIOS mode to MBR Legacy to UEFI mode. The AIO boot file is already installed on FAT32 UEFI disk. Now you should shut down the VM or reboot to change BIOS mode, legacy to UEFI mode. Go to Edit Virtual Machine Settings. Go to Options. Go to Advanced. Change firmware type BIOS to UEFI. Then click OK to save change. Now start up VM Windows 10. Sometimes WinPE and setup on VM is not open on. This mode is the PC or laptop can able to open it easy on the mode. But if you see this message, there's another way to boot WinPE on UEFI and Clover on Grub2. Go to Clover. Go to Search Refind. Now you will go to /boot/WinPE x64DFI. Go to dlcboot.winpe10x64bit to start up WinPE. After done boot up DLC boot WinPE 10, you can use it as will to fixing the system and back up Windows 10. It's now ready to running DLC boot WinPE 10 on UEFI mode in MBR disk 2. Now let's reboot DLC to boot up Windows 10. To boot up Windows 10 on UEFI mode, you should go to boot OS on hard disk. Go to Windows 7/8.1/10 on harsh DMD3 to boot up Windows 10. As you can see, Windows 10 MBR disk is boot up on UEFI mode. You can check BIOS mode on system information. Run as administrator. Click Yes. It's only set on BIOS mode, UEFI, on Windows 10, MBR, plus AIO boot, DLC, boot 10x64. Hopefully you enjoy the video with the guide. It's now AIO boot EFI already running on Windows 10 MBR. Don't forget like, subscribe and share with yours friends. Thank you for watching.